Photographers are real. They are very professional and very aesthetic sense.
I didn't realize that India had such diverse climates in the country, so it was fascinating to see all the pictures and the monasteries, and it's a very beautiful country.
It's fantastic. I think, you know, you get a good, great feeling when you come here inside, right? So you get to see a lot of photographs, and, you know, you get to see a lot of different cultures, and, you know, especially from the north, you know, you usually don't get this kind of photos to see outside, right? It's one in all. You get everything to see in this compartment, or, you know, call it a building here. So it's a great experience to be here.
Yeah, the photography is great. So it displays like all aspects of India. I mean, like the northern part, east, west, south, everything. And the photography is great.
Hi, I'm Sriram. I am one of the directors of Data Photography. We started Data about 4 years back in 2011. We started off at Hampi, you know, which was very close to our heart. The reason was that, you know, it's one of the places where we can capture different kinds of photographs, from landscapes to people to you know, wildlife and stuff. And that actually went well with the goal of Data, which was to mentor photographers, you know, in different fields of photography, and also to help them travel the world from you know, with the goal of photography. So it's been 4 years now, and we've traveled to more than 25 destinations across the country, ranging from the mountains in Ladakh and Bhutan and Spiti, all the way to the islands of Andaman, to the forests of central India and south India. And it's been a great journey so far. More than 1,000 photographers have either done workshops or traveled with us over the last 4 years. And we felt that it was the right time to put together a collection of the photographs that have been shot on these tours. Because we have, from every photography tour, there's many great photographs that come out of it. And we wanted to kind of give them a platform to be displayed. And that's the reason we've come out with the initiative of Wanderlust this year, where we are actually displaying the photographs by more than 40 of the photographers who've traveled with us. So it's a collective of photographs from all our tours, which we've done across the country and even to places like Myanmar and Cambodia and stuff, with the idea of showcasing people's work. The other motive of Wanderlust is also to start something called the Data Photography Grant. This is something that's been close to our heart right from the beginning. So we plan to set up a grant that can actually fund photography projects with a tangible outcome. and the proceeds from the sale of the prints of the exhibition are essentially going to be used to set up this grant. So once the exhibition is over, we'll actually invite people to apply for the grant, and you know, we'll fund the projects based upon their merit. The response has been fantastic so far. We've had a lot of people walk in. A lot of people have been fascinated by the photographs that we've put up over here. A lot of interest has been generated in photography. It's been great so far.